Assalamu alaikum, dear friends. Today we are going to discuss the topic language study. It is a compulsory question for 20 marks in standard 9th and 10th. It means 20% weightage is given to this question in your paper format. Here it is the question number 1A for 16 marks and question number 1B for 4 marks. In question 1A, there will be 8 sub-questions. Each question will be for 2 marks, and question 1B, there will be 3 sub-questions. In question 1B, one sub-question will be for 2 marks and 2 questions will be for 1 mark. Like this, question number 1A and B will be for 20 marks. Now let's see the details about the sub questions of question number 1A and B. First of all, see question number 1A. In question number 1A, the first question will be, complete the words by using correct letters. Here you will be given 4 different words. You have to fill these 4 words with proper letter and have to make a meaningful word. Each word will be for half mark. After completing the correct spelling of each word, you will be assigned 2 marks for this question. Now let's see the example. Look at the first word. It is SH-PE. Second word is VOI-E. Third word is FLI-HT. Fourth word is W-RRY. Here you have to add either vowel or consonant in the blank space to make a meaningful word. It means you have to complete the word by using the correct letters. So, if you are adding A to the first word, it will be shape. If you are adding C to the second word, it will be wise. If you are adding G to the third one, it will be flight. And if you will add O to the fourth one, it will be worry. In this manner, you have to complete the first question of question 1A. Now, the second question is very simple. Just the instruction of this question is, copy the sentences correctly. Just 4 different kinds of sentences will be given here, and you have to copy these sentences as it is in your answer sheet. But remember, my dear friends, here 3 important things will be observed. The first one is mannerism of writing. Second one, that is most important, the spelling of the words that you are writing. And third, that is most important to all of, is the punctuation marks. The punctuation marks that are given in the copying the sentence will be observed very carefully. Let's see the examples of this question, copy the sentences. Then, what the secret of your energy? It is the first sentence, and if you are going to copy this sentence, let's see, the sentence has the inverted commas, the question mark, and the contracted form is used. Here, if you are copying the sentence and missing anything, that time you will lose the mark. It's a very simple, in short, we can say that you have to scan the sentence as it is. You have to xerox the sentence as it is. That is the mannerism of writing. Second example, we won't get a taxi in the rain. Now in this sentence, again, the contracted form of will not is used here, and the full stop is at the end of the sentence. The same thing will be observed. The third one, I am going to extinguish the fire. It's a very simple sentence or statement. Here, the I will be capital. There will be full stop at the end of the sentence. And rest of the things are very simple. The fourth one, so there you are, cried Mrs. Bhushan. In this sentence, the exclamatory marks is given. The sentence is written in inverted commas. And the proper noun Bhushan is there. The B is a capital, Mrs. M is a capital. All these things will be observed by the examiner. Again, I am telling to you, it's a very simple to get the 2 marks from this question. But if you are committing any grammatical, mistake related to punctuation mark, if you are committing any spelling mistake, or if you are not following the mannerism of handwriting, that time you will lose the mark. So, my dear friend, while copying the sentence, please open your eyes properly and copy it in a proper manner. Now the third sub question is, put the words in alphabetical order. It is a dictionary skill question. In this sub question, 2 different types of questions will be given. In bit 1, 4 words will be given with the beginning of different letters, and in second bit, again 4 words will be given with the beginning of same letters. Here there will be no spelling mistake letters. Here the student just have to arrange both the bits alphabetically or correctly. Each bit question is for 1 mark. The word should be arranged according to their occurrence in a dictionary skill. This question is related with the dictionary skill question. It is very easy. If you know A to Z, ABCD, then you can easily arrange this question and you can get 2 marks. The 4th sub question will be, punctuate the following sentences. Here you will get 2 different types of sentences and you have to punctuate the sentences. Punctuation means the use of full stop, colon, semicolon, comma, question mark, dash or hash, exclamation mark, and so on. That is apostrophe. Maybe the hyphen. Remember here, no need to correct the spelling of any word. It means you will not get a wrong spelling word in punctuation. Here the use of capital and small letter will play a very important role. Now let's see the example. She said, I am doing my bit. If you want to punctuate this sentence, it will be punctuated like this. She said, I am doing my bit. The word S will be capital. After said will be the comma. I will be the capital. And I am doing my bit. This sentence will be in inverted commas. And the full stop will be at the end of the sentence. And after full stop, the commas will be given. And the second sentence, what's the secret of your energy? I asked. Again, if you'll punctuate this sentence, it will be like this. What's the secret of your energy? I asked. So in this sentence, you have to add apostrophe, comma to the S, to the what word. And at the end of the sentence, you have to add question mark and after that inverted commas. Then the I will be capital and after ask, you have to put the full stop. It means you have to follow all the rules of punctuation marks. My dear friend, generally, the sentences related with direct indirects are asked in punctuation mark. So, you can take the help of the topic direct indirect for copying these sentences or for solving this question. So in this manner, by using the different symbols of punctuation mark, you have to write the answer of this question. Now the next question will be, it will be fifth question, or it will be the fifth sub question of question number 1A. And the question is, make four words, minimum three letters, using the letters in the word responsible. It means, by using the letters of responsible word, you have to make four words with minimum three letters. Each word carry half mark. Remember my friend, you have to make or write only four words. But here, it is my kind and humble request to all of you to make at least 6 to 7 words to manage your wrong words or maybe the words you have committed spelling mistake. But remember again one thing, if you have 100% confidence, then only write 4 words with minimum 3 letters. For example, the word given to you was responsible, and you can make these words from that responsible word. First one, response. Second, noise. Third, sensible. Fourth one, one. Sun, sin, nib, noble, pole, pune, nor. These are the all words that are written with the help of the letters given in the word responsible. Here you have to write only the four words with minimum three letters. And the simplest word is one, sun, sin, nib. These are the simple words you can write. Each word carries half mark. If you write all the four words with the proper spelling by using the words from the responsible, then you can get 2 marks out of 2. Now my dear friend, the next question is the 6th bit, and the question is, spot the error and rewrite the sentence correctly. Here you will get 2 sentences with one single mistake in each sentence. Here being a student, you should have the clear idea about the tenses and the word formation. Then and then you can solve this question. It means first of all you have to read the sentence, then you have to find the error in the sentence, or you have to find the grammatical mistake especially in this sentence. Each sentence is for 1 mark. Now let's see the example. For example, I have arranged it all. Now if you want to find the error in the sentence, you can easily find it that it is a present perfect tense, and here the arrange is written in the first form. So being the present perfect tense, you have to write the third form of the verb. So while writing the answer of this sentence, you can write like this: I have arranged it all. If you will write the third form of arrange in your answer, you will get full 1 mark. Now the second example. Shakir was not the courage to disobey his father. In this sentence, there is no main verb. So by replacing the auxiliary verb, you have to write the main verb of a past tense. And according to sentence, you have to use had at the place of the auxiliary verb was. And after that, the sentence will be like this: Shakir had not the courage to disobey his father. It means you have to use had as a verb in this sentence. So in this manner, you can write or rewrite the sentence after spotting the error. Or first of all, spot the error and rewrite the sentence with correct answer. Now my dear friend, the next sub question, that is question number 7, and the question is, write the related word as shown in the example. It is a very simple question. You can easily write the answer of this question. Here may be possible that you will get a hint. Here you have to add four words related to village. The given word is a hint for you. The word is small. It is showing that it is a describing word or it is an adjective. So it means it is a clear hint for you that you have to add all the four words or rest of the words that are or that should be adjectives. So you can add all the four adjectives to the noun village, and you can add, for example, quiet, remote, beautiful, lonely. All these four words are adjective, and you can add these adjective related with this word village. It will be called as a describing question. Now, the last sub question of question number 1A is a big one. It has four instruction or four directions in it. Now, first of all, see the question and read the question very carefully. The question is, complete the word chain of a noun. Add four words each beginning with the last letter of the previous word. It is a vocabulary skill question. Students should be very careful while writing the answer of this question. The first instruction is that all words should be noun. All four words should be noun. Second instruction, that there should be four words beginning with the last letter of the previous one. It is a question just like Antakshari in Hindi. But my dear friend or dear student, if you will be little bit careful, then easily you can write all four words. Now let's see the example. The word given here is a chair. The last letter of the word chair is R. So you can write rose starting with R. The last letter of rose is E. Then you can make the word elephant by using the letter E. The last letter of elephant is T. Then you can make temple. The last letter of the temple is E. Then you can make earth. In this manner, you have to complete the chain of word by using the last letter of the previous word. It's a very simple. It's a vocabulary type of question. You can write any words related with the last letter. So, my dear friend, there are 8 sub questions from question number 1A. Each sub question is for 2 marks. If there will be 4 bits, then each sub bit will be for half mark, and if there will be 2 sub bits, then each bit will be for 1 mark. Remember, here you will get either 2 bits or 4 bits. It means maybe the question will be for 1 mark or maybe for half mark. Now let's go toward the question 1B. This question is for 4 marks. Here there will be 3 questions. One sub question will be for 2 marks and 2 questions will be for 1 mark. Now the first question from this section is, make a meaningful sentence by using the phrase get rid of. Here you will get different types of the phrases. You should have the collection of number of phrases. The phrases will be so simple. First of all, you have to understand the meaning of the phrase, and then you have to write your own sentence by using this phrase. It means you have to make a single meaningful sentence by using the given phrase. Here you can get any phrase, but first of all, try to understand the meaning of that phrase, and then you have to use that given phrase in your own sentence. It is for 1 mark. See, here the phrase given is get rid of. And if you want to make a sentence, you can make like this: I get rid of bad habits. Here you can use either present, past, or any form of the verb. You are free to write either the first, second, or third form of the verb, but you have to make a meaningful sentence. Now the second question from question 1b is, add a prefix or suffix to make a new word and use any one of it in your own sentence. Again here there is a two different types of instructions. Let's see the example. For example, the word able is the first word and the second word is agree. And if you are adding un to able, it's a prefix. So unable will be the prefix. And if you are adding ment to agree, it will be suffix and it will be agreement. So by adding prefix and suffix, you can make a meaningful word as unable and agreement. And then you have to make a sentence by either using unable or by either using agreement. You have to make any one sentence either by suffix word or by prefix word. For example, you can make like this. If you are using the word prefix word, you can make the sentence like this: I am unable to understand. Or if you are using the word suffix, then you may write like this. Or you can make a sentence like this: I have an agreement with that company. In this manner, you will get 1 mark for adding the prefix and suffix, or 1 mark for making a sentence either by prefix or by suffix. It means you have to make or add the, it's a compulsory to add prefix and suffix to the word, but while making the sentence, you can use either only suffix or prefix word. Now, my dear friend, the last one or last bit is only for 1 mark. Here you will be given either main clause or subordinate clause. The question will be like this: add a clause to expand the sentence meaningfully. Here, if the main clause will be given, then the students have to add meaningful subordinate clause. Or if the subordinate clause will be given, then students have to write the main clause. For example, he failed in exam. We have to expand the sentence, we have to add the clause to the sentence. If you read this sentence, you will find it is a main clause. He failed in the exam. First try to understand the meaning and then add the clause to it. It is a main clause, so you have to add subordinate clause to this sentence. And then by adding the subordinate clause to this sentence, you can make this sentence like this: he failed in exam because he did not study well. In this manner, you can expand the sentence meaningfully. So my dear friends, these were the examples and discussion of language of study. Question 1b is for 16 marks and question 1a is for 16 marks and question 1b is for 4 marks. So my dear friend, take the help of your teacher. Try to understand each and every question and every bit carefully. Read the instructions carefully. It is very easy to get 15 to 20 marks in this question 1 and B. The question name is language study. But just one thing, you have to do the practice at your home or at your own. We know that practice makes man perfect. Hope you will understand this proverb and you will work hard. Have a nice day. इंशाल्लाह फिर मुलाकात होंगी एक नए वीडियो के साथ. अल्लाह हाफिज़.